In this video, I want to talk about Photoshop colors and how you set colors in Photoshop and all about brushes. So let's get started. Go to File, New, and over here you could just click the photo icon and use the default Photoshop size. I'll just press Create here. These are just the dimension. It really doesn't matter. I'm just going to show you brushes and colors here. We're really not creating anything from scratch. So press Create, and here's our canvas. So first of all, let's talk about colors. So the Photoshop colors here, this is your foreground color and this is your background color. So to change these, you'll just go ahead and click one of these icons. So I'll just click this one and I should get this color picker here. So you could either use this elevator here to change the lightness and the darkness of the color that you've chosen, or you could just click around here to pick a color. And if you're creating something for the web, sometimes it's good to click only web colors, and it limits your colors that you could choose, and you could get this number to use in HTML code, for example. But in this case, I'll just freely browse around and I'll pick a color I want. Let's say if you want to pick a deep red and make it a little bit darker, and press OK. So now that's our foreground color, meaning everything we create now is going to be this color. So if I went to the tool and chose the rectangle tool, you see the fill color is based on this color. So if I drag, it will create that. So I'm just going to press Command Z to undo. So your background color, you could choose that one separately too. Let's say we're going to pick this blue color, press OK. I could switch the foreground and the background. Right now, the foreground is red. If I press this arrow icon here, it switches it. So now if I click and drag a rectangle, it's going to be blue. So you get the idea here. It created a new layer for me. I could just click this layer and delete. So over here, just to make sure we're looking at the same thing, go ahead and pick the Essentials layout here. And let's start working with brushes. So the brush tool over here is shortcut B, or you could just select it here, the brush tool. And just to reset the tool, we'll come over here and I'm just going to right click or command click and reset the tool. So we're all looking at the same thing here. If you click this, you'll see all the different settings for the brush tool. For example, the size of the brush. So right now it's very small. It's this dot here. If I make it bigger here, let's say if I go to 118, you see it gets bigger. And even at 500, it gets even much bigger. And the hardness of the brush. And I'll show you that when we start working with a brush. And these are your presets. These might look different. These are just my presets, my recently used brushes. But you could get hard rounds, you could get soft rounds, you could just have a lot of different options here with brushes. So let's just go ahead and start with a soft round brush, and hardness would be around 50 and the brush size around 124. So that's going to be our default brush. So to start painting with your brush, you just click and drag just like that. You start painting with your brush. So if you wanted a smaller brush, you just reduce the size here and then paint again. And if you want a different type of brush, like a hard round brush, same kind of thing. So you see the difference here. The soft round is just kind of softens the sides, and the hard round is just is very hard edges. And some of the other settings that are good to know are the opacity here. So the opacity, if I lower the opacity to, let's say, 50, my brush is just going to be more transparent. So if I draw a couple of them on top of each other, you see the transparency shows through. Okay, next is the flow of the brush. So if I lower the flow to 50%, let me just bring the opacity up. You see the flow is not at 100%, so it has a different effect when you start drawing a line. So that's the flow. So if it's at low, if it's at like 3%, it's hardly going to draw anything. And at 100%, it's going to be just that hard line that we created before. And the soothing is really a good thing to learn about. So let me just change my brush size to, that's good, about a 30. And the soothing right now, let me just change it to 0 to show you what this does. If I draw a line, you see it's kind of hard to keep it very smooth. And if I change the soothing to 100%, it's going to just do it for me. It's going to be just a lot easier to create smooth lines here. The one where I had the soothing at 0, you know, it's a lot harder to create those. But with soothing on, it's just a lot easier to move around. It just guides you a lot better. So you could play with soothing to get the right effect that you're looking for, and there's multiple options with the soothing that I won't go into in this video, but you could play around with these as well. And just like everything else with blend modes, everything has a blend mode, so do brushes. So I'll get to blend modes in a different video. and you could come back and play with the different blend modes in a brush. Let me just go to edit and fill here. I just want to basically start with a new blank canvas. I'll just click here and fill with white, press OK. That'll just give me a new canvas so I could show you a couple other things. Again, with the brush tool, if you want to create a straight line, you could click and hold shift, and then it will restrict your movement to be straight. And if I click here and I click shift and I start moving down, same kind of thing. So if I'm not holding shift, it'll kind of be free flowing either way. But if I hold shift, it restricts my movement. If you want to create a line between two points, click once and then hold shift and then click again, and it creates a line for you. So now I could click again and click again and click again. This gives you a really nice way to draw straight lines between points. Obviously, there's a whole world with brushes. Like over here, if you look, if you don't see this window, just go ahead to window and choose brush settings so you could see this window that I'm looking at here. But over here, you could see all the different brushes that I have access to. And I've downloaded a bunch more from a website. So if you Google Photoshop brushes, there are some websites where you can buy these. For example, I have a smoke brush here. So when I use a smoke brush, it creates effects like that. I have even a brush that looks like a leaf. So if I want to create an effect like this. So brushes are very limitless in their possibility, and they really give you a lot more creativity. And I'm just going to change my brush color here just by switching the two. So if you want to change the way you're drawing with brushes, all you got to do is click here and change your ground. So if I want a green leaf here, all I got to do is do that. And again, I could increase my brush size to make a big one right over there. I hope this basic overview with brushes got you started. In the description, I want to leave you a couple links that are really handy. One is a place where you could get more brushes. So just like mine, as you can see, I have a lot more brushes than you probably have access to. So I'm going to just leave a link to that. And I also want to leave you a link to a tablet, because with a tablet, it's going to be pressure sensitive. So if you start working with brushes, you could start using a tablet to really fine-tune your drawing. If brushes and drawing are gonna be the main use of Photoshop for you, I really recommend a tablet. So in the link below, I'll leave the industry standard one that's really well priced and works perfectly. So if you're working with brushes, go ahead and pick one up just to really help with your workflow. In the next video, I'm gonna really dive into transforming things, meaning free transform tool, scaling things, rotating things, and all about moving shapes around in Photoshop. That's coming up next.